I'm Yair Wall. I'm class of 26, and I go by he, him.
I'm Varun Sasisekaran. I'm class of 2025, and I also go by the he, him pronouns.
I'm Jaden Pina. I use the he series, and I am class of 23. The Bubs were founded back in, I guess, fall of 1962, spring of 1963 is still like a little up in the air.
The Bubs have done a lot of cool stuff in the past. We voiced the warblers on Glee. We were on the sing-off.
It's so funny. Like, I feels like once a week or like once a month, a side chat post or something will blow up. Like, why are the Bubs like not as cool as I thought they were? And it's like, all right, yeah, that stinks to hear. But we aren't as cool as we used to be. And 4 or 5 years ago, when I was getting into the group, it was still like, oh, we still have to live up to the hype of being like the warblers on Glee. And we're like, no, how about we just be like the 2019 group
people.
And like, we can just sing at our home shows and like, come like chill with the other a cappella groups and not think we're like, I don't know, I don't want to swear, but like hot shit. I don't know.
1, 2, 3, 4. Here I am, signed, sealed, delivered, I'm yours.
I'm signed.
You got my future in your hands, baby.
I'm yours. And I'm gonna be yours.
And here I am, baby.
Yeah.
I'm yours.
I'm signed, yeah. Sealed, delivered.
You got my future in your hands, baby.
I'm yours. And I'm gonna be yours.
And here I am, baby.
Yeah.
I'm yours.
I'm signed, sealed, delivered.
I'm yours, baby.
I'm yours.
And I'm gonna be yours.
And here I am, baby.
I'm yours.
I'm signed, sealed, delivered.
I'm yours, baby.
I'm yours.
And I'm gonna be yours.
Something that we really emphasize when we're performing is like looking like we're having the best time of our lives. Like the way we kind of look at it is like there's someone in this room that hasn't seen us perform before, so like let's give them the best show of their lives.
When I first saw the Bubs, it really just looked like everyone, it didn't look like people were trying. Everything looked so casual and it just came naturally. And then I got here and every gig I have to work on remembering to smile in addition to doing all the movements at the right times and also remembering my part because we also sing in addition to our dancing.
And that was a big thing for me coming in specifically. Like I was like, I wasn't as loose of a freshman.
Oh yeah, tight hips, couldn't
well,
dance.
Well, tight hips, but also just like, yeah, I didn't love to like be super whatever, like
Performative,
yeah. And I think like once you're an old guy, like you've been in the group for a year, you kind of like learn that performative aspect and it's like something you pass down to like the newer members. Mm-hmm. Cause that's like the brand of the Bubs, I guess, like just having fun and trying to like spread that as best as we can.
A one, a two, a one, two, three, four.
Where it began, I can't begin to know it, but then I know it's growing stronger. Was in the spring, then spring became the summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along? Good times never seem so good.
Thank you a lot.
So I have taken like the informal role of diversity officer of the Bubs, and that is something that's super important to me, making it, the Bubs as inclusive of a space as possible. And also as diverse of a space as we can make it.
Like kind of getting away from that like 2010s, the Bubs are like the hottest thing ever type of like image that the group in the past had created. It's really important to like achieve that goal of bringing people from like a lot of diverse backgrounds, because this group was like historically straight white men.
Something that I've been really trying to do, and something that we've done, we've made strides with, where we have like way more people of color in our group than we did 5 years ago, 6 years ago. We have way more LGBTQ plus folks in our group than we did 10 years ago. So we've made strides, but like there's never enough. So that's like been my personal goal in the Bubs, just trying to diversify our group as much as possible and like make us as welcoming of a space as we can be.
3, 4, 1, 2.
I'ma get your heart racing in my skin tight jeans, be your teenage dream tonight.
You think I'm pretty without any makeup on? You think I'm funny when I tell the punchline wrong? You know you get me, so I'll let my walls come down. Before you met me, I was alright, but things were kinda heavy. You brought me to life, now every February you'll be my Valentine. Valentine,
let's go all the way
tonight. Just love,
we can dance
until we die. Take a chance and don't ever look. We drove to Cali and got drunk on the beach. Got a motel and built a fort out of sheets. I finally found you, my missing puzzle piece. I'm complete.
Let's go all the
way tonight. Just love.
We can dance until
we die. Your chance and don't ever look.
I'ma get your heart racing in my skin tight jeans, be your teenage dream tonight. Let you put your hands on your teenage dream tonight.
It's the craziest thing ever. It's like you're just automatically, like, no questions asked, welcomed into this like family of 300 members, because like our alumni,
involved.
Yeah, they're super involved. And like you'll get calls from some guy that graduated in like 67, like, congrats on getting in the group, like, text me if you need anything. Like, it's like a super, I don't know, comforting feeling. And like, you don't really understand the extent to which that like is a thing until you're kind of living it?
It's when I first joined the group, which was about a month ago, slightly more. At first I thought it was going to be like very like bro culture, like, and then I got here and it was just like a bunch of people who just loved me for just like being there.
Again, like thinking back to how I decided to like audition for the Bubs, it was like so random, just some random kid I saw in DeWick wearing a Beelzebub sweater. And then after I had auditioned, I was like, you know what, I don't care if I get into the group. That was like the most fun I've ever had in my entire life. And then thinking to like the memories that I've made with the Bubs, it's like that is some of the most insane things that you could ever imagine. I didn't think like, oh, I'm gonna join the Bubs so I can be on TV. Like, mm-hmm. I was like, okay, I'm just gonna go sing with these guys like at rehearsal and sing for some home shows, and it's been like everything and more. It's nuts.
Nothing, girl, baby. Here I am, signed, sealed, delivered, baby.
Red pants.
Oh god.
These were Amazon.
Yeah, I got mine on a like a clearance rack. They were like special sized, and someone I guess had returned them to like I don't know, someplace randomly downtown.
That's a crazy find, I'll tell you.
That like, was a crazy red pants.
No. Like I asked someone at Macy's if they had red pants, and they looked at me like I was an alien.
Yeah. Low market right now for red pants. The market's at an all-time low.